Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, having seen through the appearance of Srimad Bhagavatam and how Acharyas revered Srimad Bhagavatam in a high esteemed position, and how the modern scientific development took place over the period of last 25 centuries. Now, let us get into the introduction to the Bhagavata Cosmology. This is all about the primary and secondary creation of the universe as per Srimad Bhagavatam, second and third canto. So, the main focus of this presentation is based on the statement. Generally, we see the words of the scriptures through our experience in this world. As we grow, since from our childhood, we gain a lot of experience, learnings from our parents, family members, relatives, friends, society, school, media, etc. etc. Whenever we come across a Vedic text, we try to analyze that Vedic text in terms of our experience in this world. But the goal of this presentation is to transform our idea of seeing this world. Now on, let us try to experience the world through the words of the scriptures. Instead of seeing through the words of the scriptures in a doubtful way, now let us see the world through the words of the scriptures. So this is our expected goal of this presentation. So the Vedic understanding of the beginning of the universe is all began with the Supreme Personality of Godhead when he desired to create unlimited universes and unlimited living entities. The creation started. It is explained in the Bhagavad Gita, Aham Sarvasya Prabhu Mattam Sarvam Pravartate Iti Matva Bhajanti Mam Buddha Bhava Samamita. I am the source of all that exists both in the material and the spiritual world. And the Vedic text known as Sri Brahma Samhita talks about the various distinctions about different abodes. Devi Mahesha Haridama Suteshu Teshu Goloka Dham Nijadamni Talecha Tasya. Goloka is situated at the topmost location, and beneath that there are many planetary systems known as Devi Dham, which is the entire material world, and Mahesh Dham, which is the abode of Lord Sadashiva, which is generally known as Brahmajyoti and Kailas Dham, etc. And then Vaikuntha, wherein unlimited forms of Lord Vishnu's reside in unlimited forms of Vaikunthas. And going inside and above that is the supreme most planet known as Goloka Dham or Krishna Loka. So among so many material and spiritual universes, now we'll get to study about the beginning, evolution, and working of one of such material universes, which is further divided into 14 planetary systems, and which is running under the supervision of Lord Vishnu, Lord Shiva, and Lord Brahma, and Mother Durga, and many other devatas, etc., etc., etc. So the whole history of this Bhagavatam began with a wonderful pastime orchestrated by the Supreme Personality of Godhead himself. One day Parikshit Maharaj went on hunting excursion. On his way, he lost the track. He was alone and he was hungry and thirsty. Searching for some sources for water and food, he happened to come across the ashram of Shamika Rishi, wherein when he was about to enter the Shamika Rishi's ashram, Shamika Rishi was sat in yoga. So even though upon being called by Parikshit Maharaj, there was no response from Shamika Rishi since he was in deep meditation. Parikshit Maharaj entered into the house and saw the yogi was sitting in meditation. Parikshit Maharaj within his mind, he thought that the sage does not want to receive me. So for not being received properly, being irritated at the act of the great sage, Parikshit Maharaj felt a little bad and he wanted to reward the sage accordingly. Thus he garlanded him with a dead snake and went home. In the meantime, the whole event was seen by the friends of the son of the sage, and the friends narrate to the son of the sage, who is known as Sringi. But Sringi became angry at the act of Parikshit Maharaj, and that Sringi cursed Parikshit Maharaj to die in 7 days. Upon hearing this curse that he is going to die in 7 days, Parikshit Maharaj, who was already feeling very morose for his bad behavior toward the great sage, and he took this as a blessing in disguise, and he wanted to fast till death. He made his son Janamejai as the emperor of the entire land, and he went to the bank of Ganga, wherein he wanted to fast till death for the next 7 days. Then, understanding that something wonderful is going to take place, all the sages from the entire universe have assembled there. Upon receiving them wonderfully, he requested them to describe the wonderful glories of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Alam Gayata Vishnu Gata. And he also asked them, please narrate me what is the highest benefit and what one should do throughout one's life and especially at the time of death to achieve that. Then some sages presented karma, some sages presented jnana, some sages presented yoga, some sages presented bhakti. They could not come to a conclusion. Then all of them thought within their minds that a wonderful personality should come and prescribe the perfect medicine for Parikshit Maharaj, since he was having only 7 days. Then Sukadeva Goswami arrived there. Parikshit Maharaj wonderfully received him and requested him to take the position on the high seat and enlighten him on the subject matter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Thus, Parikshit Maharaj puts forward a couple of questions in front of Sukadeva Goswami. He says that, Atha Purushami Samsiddhim Yoginam Paramam Guru Purushasyeha Yatkaryam Riyamanasya Sarvata. I ask the Supreme Guru of the Yogis, what is complete perfection and what is to be done at all times for attaining that perfection for a man about to die? This is the first question requested by Parikshit Maharaj, and the second question he poses as, Eshrotavyam Mato Japyam Yat Kartavyam Rubi Prabhu Smartavyam Bhajaniyam Va Bhuri Yadva Viparyam. O Master, please tell me what men must hear, chant, remember and worship, or what they should not hear, chant, remember or worship. These are the two questions posed by Parikshit Maharaj unto Sukadeva Goswami. Hearing these two questions, Parikshit Maharaj at the Sukadeva Goswami at the beginning glorifies the questions of Parikshit Maharaj. Then he speaks about what one should not do, one should not hear, one should not chant, one should not remember, or one should not worship. Then he speaks about what one should hear, chant, remember, and worship throughout one's life, specifically at the time of death, so that one can attain the supreme and complete perfection. So, then he speaks. Sukadeva Goswami says that ultimately one has to chant, remember and worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead, his wonderful name, form, qualities and activities. That should be the prime subject matter of a person throughout one's life and especially at the time of death. And Parikshit Maharaj, upon hearing that, he understood that the subject matter to be heard, remembered and chanted is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Now, I desire to know how the Lord, by His energy, creates this universe, which is hard to meditate on by even the Devatas. Bhuya eva vivistami Bhagavan Atma Mayaya Yatedam Srujate Vishwam Durvi Bhavyam Adhishwarai. So Parikshit Maharaj thought that now I have 7 days. First, let me hear about the activities of the Supreme Lord in relation to Mahamaya, about the Srishta Leela and the maintenance Leela of the universe. And eventually, I will get to hear about the Lord's wonderful pastimes with respect to His Chit Shakti, such as the wonderful pastimes of Lord Sri Krishna in His Bala Leela, lifting Govardhan and performing Makkanchor Leela, etc., etc. Then, Srila Sukadeva Goswami, quoting the conversation between Brahma and Narada, he explains the Srishta Leela in brief to Parikshit Maharaj. So wherein in his discussion he begins to say that previously once Narada Muni also approached Lord Brahma and asked the similar questions. Please explain the truth about the characteristics of the universe, its shelter, the purpose by which it was created, into what it merges at destruction, and what it is dependent, and of what it is composed of. Yad rupam yad adhishtanam yad srishtam vidam prabhu yad samstam yad param yatya tat tatvam vada tatvataha. So these are the six questions posed by Narada Muni. Sri Brahmaji briefly describes the six answer to the six questions, and then eventually also speaks about the Leela Avataras of the Supreme Lord in brief. And having stopped his conversation, Sukadeva Goswami becomes silent. Understanding that Parikshit Maharaj thought in within his mind that Sukadeva Goswami is hurried to leave this place because Sukadeva Goswami does not stay more than the time required for milking a cow at a place of a family man. So you want to keep Sukadeva Goswami for the next 7 days. Thus he poses so many questions about all subject matters of the Supreme Lord. Then he concludes his question saying that Sarvam Yetacha Bhagavan Pruchato Me Anupa Purvacha Tatvato Arahasi Udahritam Prapannaya Mahimune. O great sage, O Lord, we should truthfully declare all this and even the what I have not asked in sequence to you, me, a soul surrender to you. So he is telling that whatever I asked, please describe the answers to those things, and whatever I have not asked, please discuss about those things if they are related to Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then understanding the eagerness and intense desire to hear about the wonderful qualities and activities of the Supreme Lord, Sukadeva Goswami begins the narration that, so before that, just to inspire Sukadeva Goswami, Parikshit Maharaj said that among all sages you are the authority like Brahma, and don't worry that my life affairs are not disturbed from fasting, but I will be disturbed by the Brahmana's death curse in 7 days. Therefore quickly tell me Lord Krishna's pastimes in detail, not just briefly. Thus, Sukadeva Goswami responds to Parikshit Maharaj saying that I will give the answer to your questions by the explanations given in the Bhagavata Purana, which was endowed with 10 characteristics and which was spoken by the Lord in 4 verses to Brahma. Upon being requested by Parikshit Maharaj in various ways, Sukadeva Goswami talks about how Brahma previously at the beginning of his birth, he performed asivar austerities at the darshan of Mahavaikuntha and at the darshan of Lord Narayana. Then Brahmaji poses 4 questions to Lord Brahma, Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu, in response, speaks 4 seed verses of Bhagavatam to Lord Brahma. And now Sukadeva Goswami is trying to say that the explanation of those 4 verses consists of 10 subject matters. Now I will speak to those things. And upon being heard by the Supreme Lord Narayana, Brahma was intensely meditating upon those verses. Then Narada Muni came to him and served him very humbly. Then being pleased with his service, Lord Brahma spoke this to his son Narada, instructing him to distribute it everywhere. So when Brahma, being requested by Narada Muni, spoke to him the same 4 verses and requested him to elaborate those 4 verses and preach it all over the universe. Tvam etad vipuli kuru. Later on, Narada spoke the same subject matter to the great sage Vyasa on the bank of Saraswati River. Seeing him dejected and morose, even after compiling all the Vedic literature, that great sage Vyasa, after compiling the Bhagavatam under the instruction of Narada Muni, spoke the same Bhagavatam to me, his own son. Now I am going to recite the same Bhagavatam to you. Kindly listen. So this Bhagavatam was originally spoken by Lord Narayana to Brahma. Brahma spoke to Narada. Narada instructed Vyasadev, and that Vyasadev compiled this wonderful Bhagavatam and instructed it to his son Sukadeva Goswami, who later on spoke that in the assembly of on the bank of Ganga, headed by Parikshit Maharaj, wherein Sukadeva Goswami begins his narration saying that Atra sargo visargasya sthanam poshana mutaya manvantareshanukata nirodho muktirashraya. This Bhagavatam consists of 10 subject matters. Those 10 subject matters are Sarga, which discusses about the primary creation of the universes, Visarga, the secondary creation of living entities, Sthanam, maintenance of the living entities, the geographical locations within the universe, which talks about the general protection to all living entities by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Poshanam, mercy, special mercy of the Supreme Lord upon His wonderful devotees, Poshanam Tad Anugraha. Then, Utaya, material activities, Utaya Karma Vasana, Manvantara, conduct of the Manus, Manvantara and Sadharma, Ishanukada, stories of the Lord and devotees, Avataranu Charitam Hare Chasyanu Vartinam, Nirodha, destruction of the universe, Nirodha Asyanu Shayanam, Atmana Sahashaktibi, Mukti, Muktir Hitva Anyata Rupam Swarupena Vyavastiti, this is liberation. And the ultimate subject matter is the Ashraya, the ultimate shelter of above all 9 subject matters. Then Sukadeva Goswami further states, Dashamasya Vishuddhartham Navana Mihalakshanam Varnayanti Mahatmana Shrutena Artena Anjasa. The great devotees such as Vidura and Maitreya describe properly the 9 topics in order to impart the highest knowledge of the 10th topic through the words of the scripture and stories to illustrate their meaning. So, in order to begin the conversation, description and elaboration of the 4th series verses of Bhagavatam, Sukadeva Goswami quote the narration or conversation between the great sage Maitreya and Vidura that took place just after the departure of Lord Krishna. So, wherein Vidura begins the conversation requesting Maitreya to discuss on the subject matter of the creation of the entire universe. This particular subject matter is technically known as Sarga, the primary creation of the universes by Lord Vishnu. And this subject matter we are entitling as the Vedic Alternative to Modern Big Bang Theory. Herein we are trying to understand the origin of the universe from Vedic point of view. This is explained in the second and third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam in quite few chapters. The subject matter known as Sarga begins by a question by Vidura to Maitreya, wherein Vidura asks, please speak about the creation of the universe of happiness and suffering. This universe consists of both happiness and suffering. So this is called as Sarga, that means Prakrita creation or primary creation. Prakrita creation means creation started with Prakriti. Primary creation means it is the very first creation of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The definition given by Sukadeva Goswami is Bhuta Matrendriya Diyam Janma Sarga Udahurta. Sarga refers to the manifestation of gross material elements, that is Panchabhutas, Tan Matras, the 5 sense objects, senses, Indriyas, 5 Jnanendriyas and 5 Karmendriyas, false ego, that is Ahankara, and Mahatattva, that is consciousness, which are caused when the Lord transforms the gunas, 3 modes of material nature. Creation of the totality of matter with 24 elements manifesting from Prakriti by Lord Vishnu's glance is called as Sarga, the primary creation. So the subject begins. Dravyam karmacha kalascha svabhavo jiva evacha vasudevat paro brahman na chanyo artha asti tatvatah. O brahmana, the elements karma, kala, svabhava and the jiva are not different from Vasudeva. Nothing but he exists in truth. So Lord Brahma speaking to Narada Muni saying that this universe is consisting of 5 elements, the 5 subject matters, that is Dravya, Karma, Kala, Svabhava, Jiva. And in truth these 5 are non-different from the Supreme Lord Vasudeva. Even in Bhagavad Gita Lord Krishna said that Bahunam Janmanam Ante Jnanavan Mam Prabhadate Vasudevam Sarvamiti Sa Mahatma Sudurlaba. One who understand that everything is non-different from me, who is known as Vasudeva, he becomes completely enlightened. So Dravya means the 24 elements, the substance of matter, which acts like Upadana Karana, or the material cause. Karma is the cause of birth, Kala is the agitator of the gunas, Swabhava is the cause of the change in the gunas. And these three act as Nimitta or efficient cause. Then finally the Jiva is the enjoyer of this entire universe. All the Jivas combined together are called as Hiranyagarbha, or the totality of Jivas, the enjoyer. This universe in truth consists of these five tattvas. This universe is made up of Maya and Jiva, which are the two energies of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So initially there was Lord Krishna. When there was a time for creation, the same Lord Krishna expands into the first Purusha, that is Karnodaksha Vishnu, who simply by his breathing creates unlimited material universes, providing a place for the living entities to perform their activities as per their desire. In the beginning, there was Karnodaksha Vishnu alone, who was lying on the ocean of Karana, on the ocean of gigantic waters. When there was a time for creation, from all his unlimited skin pores appears all the universes in their seed form, which is technically known as Pradhana. So as Lord wants to create unlimited universes, he looks into that Pradhana. That Lord's glance consists of Kala, Karma and Swabhava. So technically we can see that this Pradhana is nothing but Dravya, which is the sum and substance of 24 material elements. When the Dravya comes out of the Supreme Lord, it is completely inactive. The three modes of material nature are completely inactive. That's why it is called Pradhana. To make it active, to activate it, Lord glances over that Pradhana by injecting Kala, Karma and Swabhava. By the interaction with these three things, with Pradhana, that Pradhana eventually transforms into Mahatattva, wherein the mode of goodness becomes activated and eventually the mode of passion also becomes activated. The state when the mode of goodness and mode of passion both are predominant, are active, that state it is called Mahatattva. Eventually when mode of ignorance becomes predominant, that state it is called as Ahankara, or Ahankara becomes manifested. Eventually from the three modes of material nature, as they become activated by the time Ahankara manifested, and the three modes transforms into three different energies known as Jnana, Kriya and Dravya. From Sattvic Ahankara appears Jnana Shakti, from Jnana Shakti manifests the mind and its presiding deity and the 10 presiding deities of the senses. And from Rajasic Ahankara, from the Kriya Shakti manifests the Prana, which enlivens everything in the universe, and the intelligence and the 10 senses. From Dravya Shakti, the Tamasic Ahankara transforms into 5 grass elements or 5 Panchabhutas and 5 sense objects or the 5 Tanmatras. The same thing we can see in a proper sequence of order. Initially there was Karnadaksha Vishnu, the first Purusha. So when he wanted to create, the Pradhana, the Maya Shakti appears from the bod, the various skin pores of the Supreme Lord, and all combined together is called as Pradhana, wherein the three modes of material nature are completely in equilibrium state. They are inactive. To activate them, Lord glances over that Pradhana. His glance consists of Kala, Karma and Swabhava. As they enter into Pradhana, the modes become active. When the mode of goodness becomes active, that state it is called Mahatattva. When the mode of passion becomes active, that state is known as Tutta Tattva. When mode of ignorance becomes active, that state it is known as Ahankara. From Tatvik Ahankara, in the mode of goodness appears mind and its presiding deity, and the present it is of the Jnanendriyas and Karmendriyas. From Rajasika Ahankara appears intelligence, prana and the 10 senses. From Tahasika Ahankara appears the 5 Tanmatras and the 5 Panchamaha Bhutas. Thus, there was the creation of 24 elements. The interrelation among the 24 elements is presented here. The 5 gross elements are here, earth, water, fire, air, ether, and their respect to Tanmatra, the sense objects are smell, taste, form, touch and sound, and they are experienced by the 5 knowledge acquiring senses, the 5 Jnanendriyas, nostrils, tongue, eyes, skin, ears, and these 5 knowledge acquiring senses are controlled by the 5 Devatas known as Ashwini Kumaras, Varuna, Sun, Vayu and Direction Devatas. The 5 Jnanendri, the knowledge, 5 action senses are, the 5 Karmendriyas are voice, hands, legs, anus and genitals, and their activities are supervised or controlled by the 5 Devatas known as Agni, Indra, Upendra, Mrityu and Mitra and Prajapati Daksha. These are the gross elements and the senses. The 4 subtle elements are mind, intelligence, false ego and consciousness. They are controlled by Moon, Brahma, Rudra and Vishu. They are also called as Man, Buddhi, Ahankara and Chitta. Thus, there was the creation of 24 elements, but these elements are separate and they were not knowing what to do. So now let us see the sequence of events. First, Pradhana manifested from the skin pores of the Supreme Lord. Lord Vishnu glanced at Pradhana. His glance consists of Kala, Karma and Svabhava. When Pradhana interacts with Kala, Karma, Svabhava, it transforms into Mahatattva. Eventually, from Mahatattva appeared Ahankara, and from Ahankara, in the mode of goodness, appeared mind and 10 sense devatas. In the mode of passion appeared intelligence, prana and 10 senses. In the mode of ignorance appeared 5 gross elements and 5 sense objects. But these elements does not know what to do. They are all standing idle, but being inspired by the Supreme Lord, they all began to pray to the Supreme Lord, requesting him that, "You have created us, please engage us in your service." Then the Lord first entered into each and every element as cohesive energy and then as Paramatma. As Lord entered into each and element to combine them so that all the further action can take place, all the elements combined together and they formed into unlimited universes, transforming themselves into the universal X or Brahmanda, manifesting all the universes with 7 shells. Each and every universe is consisting of 7 shells made up of 24 elements, the 7 layers. That's why it is called as Brahmanda or Hiranyanda, the anda made up of 7 layers of the universal elements. So these unlimited universes are floating on the causal ocean lifeless for so many years. Lord Vishnu, when he wanted to further the creation, the same Karnadaksha Vishnu expanded into unlimited Garbhadaksha Vishnu forms, taking all the collective jivas who are supposed to go each and every universe, entered into each universe. As he entered into the universe, he finds entire darkness. There was nothing in the universe. Then he created from his own body the water and filled it in the lower half and filled the upper half with the eternal sky. Then he wanted to take rest. He entered into that Garbhadaka ocean and began to recline on the bed of Lord Anantashesha. Mother Lakshmi was performing his Padasevanam. And then further, when he wanted to create further the creation, he looked into his own abdomen wherein all the living entities are taking rest. As he looked into all the living entities within his abdomen, all the living entities with their karma and svabhava appeared pushing forth through his navel in the form of a lotus stem, lotus flower and lotus leaf. And then when Lord wanted to further the creation, Lord himself entered into this lotus flower as Paramatma. As he entered as Paramatma, appeared Lord Brahma, the four-headed Lord Brahma on the top of the lotus flower. And Bhagavatam further says that, thus The creation in the beginning manifested in three forms. The first form is the grass, lotus, flower. The second form is known as Hiranyagarbha, the saman substance of all the living entities. The third form is the first living entity who is representing all the living entities is four-headed Lord Brahma, who appears on top of this lotus flower. Thus, it is said that the totality or the samishti Virat will become the lotus stem arising from the Lord's navel, and this lotus stem will become the grass form of the universal form with 14 planetary systems. From this lotus appears eventually the 14 planetary systems, wherein unlimited living entities can take shelter. It will also become the subtle Hiranyagarbha, the form of Brahma, consisting of the totality of jivas. All the living entities who are going to occupy this entire 14 planetary system are called as Hiranyagarbha. And it will also become the four-headed Brahma who carries out creation. As Lord entered into the lotus as Paramatma, the first living entity who is the leader of the entire Hiranyagarbha appeared as the four-headed Brahma who will continue the creation further. Thus, Lord appeared in three phases, that is grass Virat Rupa, subtle Virat Rupa, which are known as Viraja and Hiranyagarbha, and eventually causing the birth of Lord Brahma, who with four heads. Thus, Brahma has three forms. First one is Viraja, second one is Hiranyagarbha, and third one is four-headed Brahma. Then Bhagavatam elaborately talks about the Virat Rupa at five places. We'll just briefly glance through what are the five places, why it is explained. The first time it is explained in the second canto, first chapter, wherein Sukadeva Goswami explains this entire Virat Rupa as a Dharanashraya for an attached yogi, so that he can become free from different variety of behaviors called as hatred, envy and other bad qualities. Because a yogi who is attached to this material world, he tries to enjoy the universe. When he sees the entire universe at the Virat Rupa of the Supreme Personality of God, non-different from the Supreme Lord, he becomes free from the qualities such as Ichcha and Dvesha, etc. Thus, he becomes qualified to go back to Godhead. And second time it is explained in the 6th chapter of the 2nd canto, wherein Sukadeva Goswami explains that whatever is seen in this creation, Lord is both its material and efficient cause. So here in Lord Brahma narrating to Narada Muni, saying that in the beginning when I was created, I saw everywhere in the universe the Supreme Lord only manifest in different forms. Collecting all the forms, I performed fire sacrifice for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord. Later on, all your elder brothers, younger brothers also underwent the same thing. Thus, there is nothing but the Supreme Lord in the entire universe. For everything, both the material cause and the efficient cause is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And third time, it is also explained in the 10th chapter of the 2nd canto, wherein Sukadeva Goswami says that it is by the desire of the Virat Rupa that he manifests various limbs of the universal form. Within the universal form, or even within the individual form, the desire creates various limbs of the form of each and every living entity and the form of the entire universe. Desire is the cause of creation. The fourth time it is explained in the 6th chapter of the 3rd canto, wherein the universal form is created by Lord Chitshakti so that the elements could perform their functions. After hearing the prayers offered by the leaders of the elements, the Supreme Lord created the universal form, creating respective places for the elements so that the elemental deities, so that they can perform their respective activities for the entirety of the creation. For example, Lord has created the eyes so that both sun and moon can perform their activities. Lord has created the nose so that the smell devatas can perform their activities. Lord has created hands, the controlling deities of the hands can perform their activities and supervise the activities of the hands, etc. And the fifth time, universal form is explained in the 26th chapter of the 3rd canto, wherein Lord Kapila speaks to his mother, telling that without the Paramatma, the Kshetrajna, the Jiva or his body cannot exist. When Vasudeva, the Antaryami, along with the Chitta, entered the heart, the universal form rose up to function. So, in spite of having so many devatas, so many controlling deities, the universal form does not function. Only when Lord Vishnu, in the form of Shivadaksha Vishnu, the Paramatma, the Antaryami of each and every living entity, the Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, the Paramatma, the entire universe, or Hiranyagarbha, becomes active, the universe becomes active, the individual body becomes active, the universal form becomes active. Thus, there is the explanation of the universal form at five places. The first time it is mentioned as the Dharanashraya for an attached yogi to become free from hatred, envy and other bad qualities. So, thus, within one universe, the Garbhodakshaya Vishnu acts like Dharanashraya for an attached yogi in his external universal manifestation, wherein all the 14 planetary systems are attributed to the different bodily limbs of the Supreme Lord, and thus different yogis meditate upon the Supreme Lord. Considering Patala to be soles, Rasatala to be heels, Mahatala to be ankles, Talatala to be calves, Sutala to be two knees, and Vitala to be lower thighs, Atala to be upper thighs, Mahitala or Bhuloka to be his hips, Bhuvarloka to be his navel, Sargaloka to be his chest, Maharloka to be his neck, Janaloka to be his face, Tapaloka to be his forehead, and Satyaloka to be his top of head. Considering all these different planetary systems as different bodily limbs of the Supreme Lord, the yogi is meditated upon the Supreme Lord. Second time is explained as whatever is seen in this creation, Lord is both its material and spiritual or efficient cause. So thus it is explained that how the subtle essence organ, the sense organ, the gross sense organ, the sense devata, the sense object and the material elements all are created and activated by the sanction of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The five karmendriyas and their subtle organs, gross organs, their controlling deities and their activities are also created by the Supreme Virat Purusha. So these are all explained in the second canto, 6th chapter. Then in second canto, 10th chapter, it is by the desire of the Virat Rupa that he manifests various limbs of the universal form. It is explained, when he desired to speak, mouth, mukham, agni manifested. When he desired to experience the fragrance of wonderful perfumes, the nostrils, the place of smelling, and Vayu and Ashwini Kumara, the control readings and the fragrant herbs are manifested. When he desired to see the eyes, the form of fire, and eyeballs, sun manifest like that. Desire causes creation of various bodily limbs and the activity become manifested. Then later on in the third canto, the universal form is created by the Lord Chitshakti so that the elements could perform their various functions. The deities of the various elements requested the Supreme Lord to engage them in particular service. So it is mentioned as Agni was created and he was given the place of the universal mouth so that one can express oneself in words and speak. And Lord created tongue and talu so that Varuna can supervise the activities of the tasting of different things all over the universe. It's like that. The various elemental deities were given activities to supervise various activities of the living entities and the preceding entities of different activities. And further, Lord also manifested the heart of the universal form and the living entity, which acts like the seat for intelligence, seat for mind, seat for ahankara and seat for chitta. Heart acts like the place for the soul, place for the super soul, and the place for four subtle elements. And from heart, these four subtle elements perform their wonderful activities. Like that, various things have become manifested in the Virat Purusha. Then Bhagavatam also explains about the creation of variety of varnas and their respective duties, their respective occupations. Then Bhagavatam summarizes about all these things again in a pictorial way. When Lord wanted to create, he glanced over his own abdomen wherein all the living entities were taking rest, all the living entities with their karma and sabhav, they appears in the form of a lotus. When Lord entered into that lotus, Lord Brahma appeared on top of the lotus flower, and then Lord Brahma tried to have the understand the source of his own appearance and his own existence. Then he searches all over the stem of the lotus, but he could not find the origin of his existence. Then he entered into tapasya. Having performed thousands of years of tapasya, then he had the audience of Lord Vishnu. Then he offered wonderful prayers unto Lord Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. Then he requests Garbhodakshaya Vishnu to empower him to do the creation as it was in the previous day. Then Lord Vishnu empowers him and awards him all the knowledge that is required to perform the further creation. Thus, Lord Brahma, who appeared on the top of lotus flower, being empowered by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Brahma, with his mature meditation and long penances, he understands that now he has to begin his creation. So before beginning the creation, with his mature meditation and long penance, he drank the devastating water and the devastating air. Then the entire universe becomes peaceful, wherein he sees the lotus flower and water and sky. After seeing these three things, he wanted to make different residences for different living entities which he is going to create in future. Thus he enters into that lotus and divides it into three parts, making them into Bhuvarloka, Bhuloka and Sargaloka. But he understands three varieties are not sufficient, he wanted to have multiple varieties. Thus he further divides that into 14 divisions and eventually it into unlimited divisions, so that unlimited variety of living entities can get the place to reside in this universe. So these 14 divisions are starting with Satya, Tapa, Jana, Mahar, Sarga, Bhuvar, Bhu, Atala, Vitala, Sutala, Talatala, Mahitala, Rasatala and Patala. Even within Swargaloka and other planetary systems, he further created into unlimited divisions, so that unlimited variety of living entities simultaneously can be coexisted after their simultaneous creation. So this is the entire subject matter of the primary creation by the three Purushas. The first Purusha is Karandasya Vishnu. From his skin pores appeared unlimited universe in their seed form, which is known as Pradhana. When Lord glanced upon that Pradhana, Pradhana transforms into 24 elements. When Lord entered into 24 elements, they combined together and formed into unlimited universal shells. The same Karnadakshaya Vishnu, expanding himself as unlimited Garbhadakshaya Vishnus and taking all the living entities along with him, entered into each and every universe and created water which filled the lower half, and he entered into that water and began to take rest. When he wanted to further the creation, from his navel appeared a lotus flower, and as Lord entered into the lotus flower, Lord Brahma appeared upon the top of the lotus flower, and by the empowerment of that Supreme Lord, Lord Brahma created 14 planetary systems from that lotus flower. This is all in the subject matter of the primary creation by Lord Vishnu or Sarga or Prakritika creation. Creation starting with Prakriti. So this is how unlimited universes were created. We are studying about one universe, wherein Lord Brahma divided that one universe into 14 planetary systems.
The night sky, the dark blanket above our heads adorned with shining stars extending as far as the eye can see. One of the most appealing and mystifying of all sights. The beauty and the majesty of the universe have inspired awe and reverence in the best brains throughout history.
There is a perfect brain behind all the natural physical laws. This most beautiful system of the sun, planets and comets could only proceed from the counsel and dominion of a powerful and intelligent being. Please describe the symptoms of this manifest world. What is its background? How is it created? How is it conserved? And under whose control is all this being done?
Here we behold a form of the superintelligent being Vishnu, reclining in mystic slumber amid the causal ocean. When he exhales, millions of universes issue from his body and expand, until he inhales when all the universes return within him. The universe is a sphere encased by successive coverings of the elements earth, water, fire, air, ether, intelligence, and ego. As a coconut has its hard outer shell and inner liquid, so the universe has its outer coverings and an inner space half filled with ocean water. On that ocean, another Vishnu expansion reclined on a serpent bed while being massaged by his consort Lakshmi. From his navel arose a lotus on which Brahma was born. Initially, the universe was pitch dark and Brahma engaged in meditation. Then he was empowered to create the universe. This account of creation may appear fantastic to some, but modern scientific theories also require fantastic leaps of faith to explain the origin of the universe. This is evident from the words of eminent physicist Stephen Hawking.
Either we have failed to see 99% of the universe, or we are wrong about how the universe began.